Coronavirus restrictions seem to have sparked a renewed interest in gardening this season. Katie Pinke has some tips for getting started with a horticulture expert.
Joining me now is NDSU horticulturist Esther McGinnis. You have an interesting background that led you to horticulture.
Well, my background has not been a straight path. I went to law school at the University of Minnesota and then became an attorney in St. Paul, practiced for 10 years, but discovered I had this passion for horticulture.
How would you recommend somebody get started in gardening this season?
Well, don't overdo it. Start small. You may want to start in some containers, try and grow some tomatoes in a container, pepper plants, maybe some of the leaf lettuces. You could plant those about this time, but the nice thing with the leaf lettuces is that you don't have to wait until a full head develops. You can actually harvest individual leaves as you need them, and that plant will continue to grow. Or you may want to start with a raised garden bed that's small, maybe 4 feet by 4 feet. And the advantages of a raised garden bed is that you can build it up so you don't have to bend over.
Tell us about the interest in Victory Gardens.
Well, the interest is really rising among gardeners. We're really kind of trying to replicate what we did in World War II, where we all banded together to help others and to also produce food for ourselves. People planting extra rows so that we can donate to food pantries. Because we are seeing this huge demand for food from the food pantries, and they really don't have huge amounts of fresh produce donated to them. So we want to fill the void and help individuals that are less fortunate, that may be unemployed or food insecure.
Esther McGinnis, you've given us a lot to think about. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Katie.